Good morning. Today is the 24th of May in the year 2015. That is today to say that today is the 66th day of spring in the Northern Hemisphere, the 7th day of the moon in the 57th year of the space age. I am pondering a number of changes in my life. Everything is ridiculous and insubstantial as a contest with a one in millions of chance of winning to something as downright every day and absolutely certain as paying the rent on my apartment in Tijuana. Now, contests are fun to dream of, especially when they involve giving away houses. I've always been a sucker for looking at house plans and looking at photographs, and for the last a couple of years now, I've been entering the HGTV Home and Garden Television Network. Every year they give away two or three houses. I can't exactly tell you how many. It keeps slipping around in my mind, and I'm not looking at the web page right now. But they have a dream house contest, and then they have a smart house contest. Now, last year, the dream house was in the area of Lake Tahoe, just outside of the town of Truckee. Beautiful location. Kind of cold in the winter, but, you know, it's the mountains. Also bears, who like to crawl in the basement crawl spaces underneath houses in the winter and sleep underneath your house, then come out in the springtime and visit your barbecue parties. Bears. I remember I was making a lot of jokes about that a couple years ago, and one of my friends online, you know who I mean. You know who I mean. Yes, well, to cut to the chase, it was Frank. He said, "Watch out for the squirrels. The bears, at least they're big and you can see them, but squirrels, those little devils, they come in hordes." Now, I may be adding a few words to his comment, but I know there is one absolute word. I'm just one word he said. He said, "Squirrel." Or maybe he said the plural, squirrels. Yes, well, look at the camera, Daniel. Don't look at the screen. Look at the camera. It's right there. Now I'd rather look down here at the screen. So back up, so you can't tell where I'm looking. As I was saying, it's Monday. No, it's not. It's Sunday. Monday's a holiday tomorrow, Memorial Day. I just can't get over not having Memorial Day on the 30th of May. When I was a child, it was always the 30th of May. Well, you know, so many holidays now are on Monday by law. So, here we are. Sunday the 24th of May. And this is the weekend that culturally summer begins. In the United States, where we celebrate Memorial Day on, I guess it's the last Monday in May, and we celebrate Labor Day on the first Monday in September. Here in the United States of America, summer traditionally is measured between those two holidays. You'll see our statistics about drunk driving and gasoline sales and miles traveled per highway and number of traffic jams and socks that fall out of open doors while driving at high-speed road rage chases through the superhighways of L.A. Hell, A. Yes, all of those statistics are measured between Memorial Day and Labor Day. But that was all just because today's Sunday and it's morning. And I don't know what the hell I'm saying. I'm half asleep, drinking coffee. I already had a bowl of beans for breakfast. I love beans. I cooked these myself. Yes, these beans I cooked myself. Yes. Now, yesterday, I went to the border. But I didn't cross over. Fortunately, my translation partner had to come across and visit some post office boxes in San Ysidro, just across the border from Tijuana. So I was able to go, and we met up, and I got paid 4,000 pesos. Sounds like a lot of money, doesn't it? But it's barely $300. Nevertheless, it's very welcome. I don't make a lot of money, and I've got some expenses. So, here we are. On the 66th day of spring, less than 30 days left until astronomically summer begins with the longest day of the year. And it's only the seventh day of the moon, and I haven't seen the crescent moon yet because it's been cloudy. We've been having very strange weather here on the southern end of California, next to the Mexican border where the other California begins. My sweet and dearly beloved wonder desert of Baja California. We've been having rather wet weather. For 3 weeks in a row, it has rained on Friday. Now, the timing is extraordinary that it would happen Thursday night and Friday 1 week, and then again the next week, and then the week after, which was night before last. But this time it's not clearing up as well. It's been cloudy, and it's been cloudy, and it's been cloudy, and it's been cloudy. And I would have seen the crescent moon a couple days ago, maybe on the third day of the moon, maybe even the second. But usually by the third or fourth, I catch a glimpse of it in the evening sky above the sunset. Well, I've seen some sunsets, but they've been through clouds. Here, I'll show you what I mean. Right. Mm. there. Okay, if I'm any good, I would have edited it in. But I haven't seen the moon. And for an old stargazer like me, that's disappointing. Maybe if I shave, the moon will come out, or rather, the clouds will open. I did read a couple poems this week. That's another thing I've been thinking about, is how can I make a few pennies on YouTube? I've already made almost $30, but they don't pay until you make $100. I'm ashamed to say it's been 4 years that I've made $30 with my videos. So, I suspect there's something I could do. I mean, it's true, maybe not a lot of people want to watch a fat old man talking, but I can read poetry good. And there are a few people who like to listen to poetry. So that's what I've been thinking about. Maybe today I'll read another poem. They're at my website, if you're not here already. YouTube, Tijuana Gringo. Well, as they say, that's about it. I should have a snappy sign-off. There's like the people who salute you, and the people who just wave bye-bye. And maybe they do this. Maybe they do three-year-next. Oh, of course, there's always vlog on. So anyway, until next time, I shall bid you a fond farewell.